Beloved, we are talking about being a good ground so the word of the Lord will produce miracles and blessings and fruitfulness and power in your life and in your own gut. Because everything comes from within. Unto him that is able to do exceeding abundantly more than we could ask or think. Isn't that incredible? Imagine it. He said God could, will do much more. But he says, according to the power that worketh in us. All of this incredible power that God has is limited to how much you've internalized. So being a good ground is a divine imperative. It's an urgent need in all of our lives that we must start pressing to be good ground so that the power of God can increase in our lives. Remember, the Bible says that the manifestation of the Spirit is there for every man to profit with all. So I have to really place a demand on these things. I have to really pursue these things so that I will be a good ground. I want to take you to the book of Luke, because Mark talked about 30-fold, a 60-fold, and then 100-fold. And then Matthew spoke about 100-fold, a 60-fold, and a 30. But trust Luke to always be different, but bring us something we haven't had. Listen to Luke. He says, but that on the good ground are they which in an honest and good heart. In an honest and good heart, having heard the word, keep it and bring forth fruit with patience. Luke. Luke 8:15. In an honest and good heart. What is so unique about that? I've said through the years that self-deception is the worst deception anybody can deal with. Why? Because you will be the only one who does not know that you are deceived. Everybody around you will know it, but you. He says, hallelujah. I was trying to quote his scripture and then lost my trend of thought, but it will come to me. He says, be ye hearers, be you doers of the word. That's it. And not hearers only, deceiving your own selves. You see? He said, in an honest and good heart, having heard the word, keep it. He says, self-deception is hearing it and not keeping it. Or hearing it, allowing it to be choked, and not even bothered that the word is choked. One of the dumbest things that we did years ago was thinking that God was the reason we were not receiving. And we're wondering, well, why is God not answering our prayers, you know? But it's not, you know, soul searching or trying to find out from the Lord what we're doing wrongly. We thought it was his fault. And then after a while in the ministry, you start hearing some dumb, strange things like, you know, I got upset with the Lord. And I'm saying, well, later on when I came out of that, I'm wondering, who are you to be upset with the Lord? What a concept. And I started wondering, what were we thinking? What was our understanding of who God is or was? I mean, how can you get upset with the Lord? He's holy, he's perfect in all his ways. What is the premise? I couldn't fathom it really when I pulled away from all of that. And it was a common thing. I got upset with the Lord, and I was wondering, who are you to get upset with the Lord? He will tap you on the head and you'll be no more. So many things. Self-deception, beloved, is terrible. He says, if you hear the word and you don't do it, you deceive yourself, your own self, your own self. So honesty, sincerity is unleavened bread. It says, in an honest and good heart, having heard the word, keep it. Because it's in the doing that we are blessed, not in the hearing. So how to put our roots down? Because he said that the guy with the stony heart didn't have any roots. It's through obedience, the subjection to the word of God, to the will of God. That's how we put our roots down. And then he says, keep it and bring forth fruit with patience. And I'll get more into that tomorrow. But you see, God takes time to grow things, and you cannot lack the fruits of the Spirit and the manifest fruit and manifest miracles. No, because these things don't happen overnight. It's a work of patience and long suffering. Luke didn't bother with the 30 or 60 or whatever. He said, just bring forth fruit. I love Luke. But I want to look more into that tomorrow. Come on, these things are powerful. They ought to put you in check. I don't know where you are, what you're dealing with, but you really need to pay attention to what the Holy Spirit is speaking to us in this season. And we love you. We'll conclude this tomorrow. Bye-bye.